It has started now. So I was telling you about the difference between the sheet and plate. So in generally, this thickness values, basically they determine the difference between sheet and plate. So sheet, as you understand, will be quite thin. So in practice, this ranges from 1 to 3 millimeters thick. And if you see around yourself, you'll see a lot of products which are made up of sheet metals. So in this module, we will briefly see what are the different operations or processes which deal with the forming sheet metal products. And the basic philosophy of these processes is same as the metal forming processes, that you induce the stress beyond the yield stress, but below the fracture stress. Abating few operations like shearing or cutting, in which you actually shear or cut the metal in two pieces. So those are some of the exceptions in this case, but most of the processes, they deal with the, you know, just changing the shape. So sheet metal operations, they generally start with raw sheets of metal, which may be of a shape which is easy to handle, like rectangular, and they have a quite large surface area. So all these materials which are considered under sheet metal, they generally have very good formability. So the formability is the ability of the material to get formed under the influence of external forces or conform to a different shape. So generally sheet metal, raw material. So here this raw material which is used in sheet metal is obtained by the rolling process. So rolling is becomes the primary process here. So by doing the rolling on a specific or a piece of metal again and again, so typically what we observe that the thickness of the sheet goes on reducing. So then that sheet is used in sheet metal operations. So sheet metal operations, they also have a different process which is not exactly forming process. So it is known as the shearing process. So it is basically a process to separate large sheets, or I can say in simple words, to cut the sheet into two or more pieces. So under shearing, there are another set of processes that we will see in detail, which include blanking, punching, piercing, notching, slitting, and nibbling. So we'll see all these processes in bit detail in the subsequent slides. Additionally, bending is used. Bending is also an operation in sheet metal, which is basically straining the sheet around a straight axis. So basically you have a sheet like this. I'm looking at the cross section. And upon bending, I change the shape to somewhat like this. So basically what I have done is I have bent the sheet on a specified angle depending on the product which is being made from this sheet. Then additionally, there are other advanced processes which may be beyond the scope of this first level course, which we will not be discussing, but you can remember the names like deep drawing, which are basically used to make convex and concave shapes on different sheets. And hydroforming is also an advanced process. So these two processes will not be discussed in the scope of this course as they are a bit advanced as of now. So if we see the applications of this sheet metal, so they are very versatile and being used in several applications. Here I have listed some of the applications which include automobile bodies. So all the cars or any automobile, bus, truck, etc. you see. So the bodies of those automobiles is essentially made up of the sheet metal. So in that case, the thickness of the sheet may be different. Means it is still called a sheet because it conforms below 6 millimeters. So then you have beverage cans, aircraft, aerospace applications, utensils in the house, etc. All those are made up of sheet metal processes. So the main advantage with the sheet metal objects is they are very light in weight and versatile. So this process of sheet metal products is very old. So it started with production of bicycles in the year 1890 and is very well suited for mass production type of scenario. So generally, if you look in terms of ferrous materials, so low carbon steel is an example of a material which is used in the sheet metal. And if in the non-ferrous, we have aluminium and titanium sheets, which are used in aircraft and aerospace applications. So these are some images of the objects which you see are made up of sheet metal. So there are plenty of objects, but the basic operations or processes, they remain more or less same to make different objects. So first of the main operation for the sheet metal operation is shearing. So essentially shearing is not exactly a metal forming process, but it is a process, preliminary process to prepare stock for stamping process. So stamping is basically a generic name given to all the operations in the sheet metal processes, where basically you can consider it similar to as you stamp something. So when you stamp something, basically you leave the impression of the stamp on the object. So similar process is being used here. And in this case, basically the shearing machine is used. So here you see this is the machine used for doing the shearing operation. So what is done in this machine, basically you pass the sheet metal here, you place the sheet metal here. And then basically this with this actuator here, so what you do is there is a blade. So essentially there is a blade which is harder than the hardness of the sheet metal. So basically this blade, what it does, it impacts on the surface of the sheet and basically it generates a crack and leads to the cutting of the sheet into two pieces. So generally what it does when it impacts, it induces shear stresses here. So shear stresses are again the stresses which are basically tangential to the surface of the object. And this, because the shear stresses are involved here, so that is why the name of the process is given as shearing. So it is very much similar as you cut paper using a scissors. So the scissors is also known as a shearing pairs. So basically you apply shear force to cut a sheet of paper in maybe two pieces or maybe more. So similar type of a thing is being done in this shearing operation. So I'll be giving you example of all the processes from daily life, considering paper as a workpiece, because with paper you will be able to understand most of the processes quite easily. So you take the scissors and cut the paper in two or more pieces. So similar process being applied here is known as shearing. The only difference which will come in is that in scissors, you are applying a mechanical force manually, but in case of machines, so they may be operated using hydraulic means, hydraulic or pneumatic means. So those are the actuators being used in these machines. So what happens exactly in shearing process? So when the shear, basically it comes in contact with the sheet. So basically it starts inducing the shear stress in the sheet, which basically leads to propagation of these cracks. So propagation of these cracks, it occurs from the die or the other end, which is there. And additionally, the crack starts from where the punch is interacting with the sheet. So all the, we can see that in all the process, this is a common phenomena. And basically the shearing, it produces an edge burr here, so which may not be smooth, which can be also smoothened by taking a different clearance. So always you will see there is a gap, which is known as C here, which is the clearance. So this gap is basically known as the clearance, which decides the final finish of the sheared product. And this is the gap between the die and the die gap and the diameter of the shear. So if you look at it, the role of clearance between the shear and the die. So basically the clearance determines the shape and quality of the sheared edge. Smaller is the clearance, then it is better the edge quality. And if we increase the clearance, for example, here you see the clearance is on a quite higher side. So generally you will see the product or the edge which is formed is not very smooth. So in this case, the clearance is generally selected in an optimum range depending from 2% to 10% of the thickness of the sheet. So that is how the clearance is decided. And then edge quality may also be improved by increasing the speed of the punch, which will basically cause a very smooth edge being developed. Then another process is basically shaving. Shaving is basically a process to trim extra material from a rough edge. So generally what happens in shearing, if we do not get a very smooth edge, which is desired, and you have a slight burr being created. So generally to remove this sheared edge or to smoothen it out, the shaving process is used, in which basically another punch of a different shape is being used, which basically in this case you will see the two edges are parallel but are not coinciding. So the trailing edge of this punch basically will remove the excess material, thereby shaving the process in one stroke. So sometimes shaving is additionally needed, or sometimes only shearing works depending on the product. So then this is basically a correlation to calculate how much punching force is needed. So this punching force is basically determined to estimate the power or the energy which will be expended to basically remove the material or shear the material. So this is basically a function of thickness of the sheet and total length which has to be sheared. And it is also multiplied by the UTS. So UTS here stands for ultimate tensile strength of the material. So ultimate tensile strength of the material is basically a property of a material which tells what is the maximum load that the material can bear before fracture. Now we look at some other operations also. This I have already discussed. Yeah, these are another set of operations: perforating, parting, notching, lancing, and slitting. So you consider here a example or a schematic of a sheet metal here, sheet metal piece. So we look at each operation one by one. So first operation, we are looking at parting. So parting, as the name itself is telling, is an operation basically to cut the sheet metal into two parts. So basically you will get two parts here. So this is a separate part than this. So you have basically parted the sheet metal. Next is perforating. So perforating is an operation which basically includes the act of creating holes or through holes. So these are basically through holes being created here in perforating. The notching. So notching is basically creating these type of notches at the edges. So this may be used for further crimping or joining of the sheet or assembling it with another sheet. So that is the purpose of creating notches. Lancing. Lancing is basically an operation where you create these type of cuts in the sheet. So if you have seen the desert cooler, so which is used in summers basically to cool a given area. So basically the pads of that cooler are basically, you will see such type of, you know, cuts are being provided through which the air may enter passing over a, you see a membrane, or sometimes there is this organic grass type of thing. So this operation of cutting this type of hanging structures in the sheet is known as lancing. So here also I have shown in a similar way. And slitting is basically not always at the edge. So lancing is mostly at the edges. It may be done, but slitting is maybe done. This type of cuts being produced in the sheet. Next is punching and blanking. So punching and blanking are similar sheet metal operations involving cutting metal on a closed outline. But both essentially differ in the sense that in terms of blanking, basically this becomes a blanking operation where you remove the material, and the removed material is actually the desired product. And in punching, basically the hole is the desired product. So if you have punched a sheet of paper with a paper punch, so you see small bits of circular sheets of paper is being produced. So those you can consider as the small bits or circular pieces of paper as blanks. And if you see the hole which is being produced, then that becomes the punch. So both processes are same, but focus is on different things. So in punching, the focus is on the hole which is being produced. And in blanking, the focus is on this metallic or the circular piece which is being produced. So other thing becomes, in this case, the scrap. Then perforating is also a type of a punching operation. Essentially, in this case, we produce a large number of holes in a sheet. So holes may range from a diameter of 1 millimeter to 75 millimeters. So generally for ventilation purposes, these perforated sheets are widely used. And they can be produced on crank presses up to, say, 3 lakh holes per minute. And for ventilation, screen guards, filters, etc., these are used in such type of products. Next is parting. So we have already discussed, parting is basically an act to shear two pieces into two or more parts. And it involves basically cutting the metal strip with a punch with two edges. And sometimes some material may also be wasted in this case. So basically you are cutting the material in a specific contour here to produce different parts. And this material which is left may not be of sufficient dimension. So that accounts for the waste in the parting process. Lensing I also discussed in detail in the previous one. So basically is used to shearing and bending. So basically lensing involves cutting plus bending and used to make tabs and vents. And this there may not be reduction of the material, but the geometry of the part is modified. So here removal of material does not take place, but just you cut it like from here and then you bend it also. So that combination of shearing or cutting plus bending accounts for the lensing operation. Then slitting is basically done with the help of these circular blades. So this type of an arrangement is used for slitting the metal sheet. So it is similar to a can opener, where the blades, they may run either on a straight path or on a curved path depending. And they generally produce some burrs which are sometimes be removed by secondary process. And then we move to the last process, that is nibbling. So nibbling is basically combination of slits and notches. So nibbling process, it is also helpful to cut contours by a series of overlapping slits and notches. So basically you have this series of overlapping notches and slits. So by overlapping these notches and slits, basically you can provide that type of a shape or a complex shape into a sheet metal using these simple tools. And these are like, again, in this case, you have a small punch and a die is there. So this die is continuously reciprocating on the sheet metal, thereby removing the material quickly. And this happens very quickly, up to 300 to 900 times per minute. And this is basically economical for several small runs. So with this, basically, I complete the discussion on the processes under sheet metal. Now, perhaps I will take questions from you from the previous lecture and this one. Yeah, so please feel free to ask questions.